Hello guys, today I'm gonna talk about how to get good marks in IMAT. The first thing you have to do at the beginning of the preparation is to take the latest IMAT exam in a real-time schedule. By doing this, you will be familiar with the latest IMAT format and you will know how you should prepare for IMAT. You will have a clear picture of your strength and your weakness and you will know how to study. Actually, some people say that we should practice old papers first and do the latest ones when the exams are near, and that's what I did, but it was not so helpful that way, because the format had changed a lot in last few years. So it's highly effective to take at least one or two of the newest papers already in the beginning of your preparation so that you know your target clearly. The next thing is IMAT test specification. I guess you already know it. It is a list of topics that will be asked in the IMAT exam. It is available for download in the Cambridge testing website. So download it and get the familiar with the topics. The next thing is to stick to IMAT topics and syllabus. All the sections in IMAT are very broad on their own. As we know, vast amount of information is available everywhere, but this is completely unnecessary for IMAT. Just stick to the IMAT syllabus and the IMAT topics. The next way is to prioritize high yield sections of IMAT at first. Remember that there are 60 questions, of which answering only 30 correctly can guarantee you a place in many universities. You don't need full 90 marks, so you don't have to study all the IMAT topics. For example, there will be just 8 questions from physics and maths, so it's not a good idea to work hard on them in the beginning because you have to utilize your time correctly. If you are not familiar with the Italian and European history and culture, you can still get enough marks by leaving the section. There will be 18 questions from biology, so it's important to study biology well. In the beginning, you should at least get a good grip of important topics, and then if you have time, you can study other topics as well. There will also be few questions in the exam that will be very hard and will take very deep knowledge. So if you are an average student like me, just let them go and focus on important topics only. You would rather learn to answer two other easy questions in the same time taken to learn a particular topic in depth. The next way is to study familiar topics or subjects you find interesting in the beginning. For example, if you have studied biology in high school and you like it, it means you have some basic ideas already, so it won't take long time to cover it. Studying a completely new topic will take a long time and dedication from you, especially if you have some gaps from studies like me. It's easy to think of getting into medical school, but remaining motivated during the preparation is difficult. So start from familiar topics, make them strong in the beginning, and then study the unfamiliar and boring topics later on. Next way is to practice a lot of questions and take the test regularly. When you are familiar with the main exam format and have covered the most important IMAT topics, you can practice IMAT papers. And when you are done with the IMAT papers, you can practice BMAT, UCAT, HUMAT papers, or any other medical entrance papers, but focus especially on the scientific knowledge sections when you are doing this. And remember to always stick to the IMAT topics and don't waste your time for questions that are not in the IMAT topics. Take tests regularly, like once in 2 weeks in the beginning, and when the exam approaches, like in August, take it regularly. And you can also take it exactly at the same time as the IMAT exam when the time is announced. This will help to train your body and brain to be fully conscious at the exact time of your exam, and you will be able to give your best. This will boost your confidence on the exam day, will reduce your exam anxiety, and you will perform better. The next thing is get clear understanding of the topics. When you study, get a very clear insight on all the topics. The IMAT exam is truly testing whether you have a clear understanding of the topics or not, and just memorization without proper understanding is not sufficient for the exam. Prepare yourself for multiple choice questions. Remember that you are preparing for a multiple choice exam. You'll be given answers with all the questions, so this means you don't have to study like you would study for a subjective exam. The best way to prepare for multiple choice question is to understand the main idea very clearly, make points, revise the main points that are hard to remember, and practice all out and lot. So these were the specific things, and there are some general things to consider as well. Get rid of any distractions. If you can already concentrate on your studies during your study time, it's good. But if you are very active in social media and can't concentrate, you should take a small break for them. Let's not say you need to completely get rid of them, but at least turn off notifications during your study time, and that's already a lot. You can target about 4 to 8 hours of 100% attentive study per day, depending on how much you can, and make a schedule to surf social media like in the evening after your target is completed. focus on effective studies rather than counting hours. I mean, if you are feeling very tired, you are not in the mood to study, or you are just not able to concentrate, you can offer a few hours of break to yourself to do something you feel like to do at the moment, or to take a small nap to recharge yourself, and then continue studying later when you feel like that. You don't have to target 10 hours of study per day. If you are attentive enough, studying 5 hours per day is also enough. So focus on attentive study hours. Keep yourself physically and mentally healthy. As you already know, physical and mental health is the must. You don't want a lazy, tired and sick brain and body during your preparation. So do some quick exercise in the morning, eat on time, drink a lot of water, make proper schedule and set your goals for yourself. This may sound funny and we may be lazy to do them, but this will improve our physical and mental health, which is very necessary for our preparation. So this was all for today. I hope this was helpful. Feel free to leave your ideas in the comment sections if you have any. Thank you so much for watching, and I have a good day.